हेलो बच्चों,
हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड. नाउ सी हियर, व्हाट एवर आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट वी विल डिस्कस इमीडिएटली. इन दैट वी आर व्हाट वी आर वी विल स्टार्ट मेटलर्जिकल ऑपरेशंस. सो मेटलर्जिकल ऑपरेशंस सी हियर, इन दैट वी कवर टू व्हाट एवर कंसोलिडेशन ऑफ ओर, ड्रेसिंग ऑफ ओर, ओके, एनरिचमेंट ऑफ ओर वी कवर्ड. देन नेक्स्ट थिंग वी कवर्ड व्हाट? Yes, whatever our ore is converted into metal oxide by calcination and roasting. We saw their examples. Now it's time to discuss, okay, what beta? Reduction of metal oxide. Okay, so see here, whatever our third, reduction of metal oxide. So in the reduction of metal oxide, okay, reduction of metal oxide means what beta? Yes, reduction means addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen. Addition of hydrogen and removal of oxygen. Okay, so if you are thinking about your CuO, cupric oxide, CuO, and if you are taking here reducing agent, so for that cupric oxide, you have to use what? This carbon. Suppose if you use this carbon as a reducing agent, so what will happen? Yes, you will get Cu plus Cu. Okay, so like that extraction will occur. Copper you will get. Okay, suppose CuO plus carbon monoxide also we can use. So what you will get? Yes, Cu plus Cu2. Okay, you will get your copper as an extract metal. Okay, I hope you understood this. Now see, cupric oxide. If suppose if we apply cupric oxide plus H2, so what will, whatever your hydrogen, it has strongly affinity towards this oxygen. So what will happen? This Cu plus H2O. So whatever these are important for your cupric oxide or, okay, these are what? Carbon monoxide, H2, these are what made a reducing agent. Okay, reducing agent. So whatever this oxidizing agent and reducing agent, it will more will clear in next topic, whatever our chemical reactions and equations. Okay, so if you are considering about a lead, okay, so see here about a lead oxide, beta PbO plus carbon. So what will get? Yes, Pb plus carbon monoxide. Okay, if suppose if you are taking PbO plus carbon monoxide, so what will happen? Yes, your metal, your lead metal you will get plus what beta? CO2. We are doing here reduction with the help of reducing agent carbon monoxide H2. Here what? PbO plus H2. So hydrogen, it has strong affinity towards oxygen, so it will take out that oxygen to form what? H2O. Understood. So whatever you are this, again, whatever this reducing agent we can use in your for extraction of copper and extraction of your lead also. Understood? Okay, so whatever your metallurgy, so this metallurgy is very much important. Okay, whatever future of any country depends on this metallurgy. Okay, so for that metallurgical process, how much, okay, it is a very much vast process. Okay, then what beta? How many workers for and how many engineers for that? Okay, so many things are important for your metallurgy. So means so many workers we want here. Okay, so basically it is a vast process. So whatever future of any country depends on this metallurgy. So as you know, day by day demand of metals and whatever your non-metal day by day increases. Okay, understood? So whatever we are teaching this, okay, whatever you are studying, so these are very much important. Don't skip this. Okay, so whatever this reducing agent for copper and for lead, keep in mind carbon monoxide and H2. Okay, Now one more here, one oxide is there, that is zinc oxide. It is, okay, it is oxidized, okay. Sorry, it is oxidized, now it is reduced by carbon reducing agent only. So whatever your ZNO is reduced in the presence of your carbon only, as a carbon reducing agent. So reduction of that oxide with the help of carbon only. Carbon as a reducing agent here only we can use. So CZN plus CO. So this also keep in mind, okay. In the presence of coke only, whatever this carbon, we call it as what, coke, or we can say it is a amorphous form of carbon. What better here? Amorphous form of carbon. Okay. And whatever this here, iron also we can reduce by this method. Okay. So that better reaction you have to complete in your notebook. Fe2O3 hematite your iron ore plus carbon, and whatever your hematite plus, yes, carbon monoxide. Okay. So these two we can use for your iron extraction. Extraction of iron from their oxide. Okay. So beta, these you have to complete, and whatever your this product you have to write in your notebook and send to me. Okay. Or personal. Understood? So we discuss here extraction of some what beta? Carbon, yes. Sorry, extraction of what we done? Copper, then your lead, then your iron, we discuss here. Okay. Now it's time to discuss with some silver oxides. Okay. Or we can say less stable oxides. What beta? Less stable oxide. So beta, less stable oxides. इनमें कौन से आते हैं? लेस स्टेबल ऑक्साइड्स में कौन से आते हैं? यस, योर सिल्वर ऑक्साइड बेटा, Ag2O, देन HgO, दीज आर व्हाट? यस, दीज आर लेस स्टेबल ऑक्साइड. बाय सिंपली हीटिंग इट विल एक्सट्रैक्ट. बाय सिंपली हीटिंग. सो सी हियर हाउ वी कैन राइट हियर. यस, 2Ag plus half O2 यू विल गेट. Ag plus half O2 you will get after, means simply heating. Yes beta, here simply heating you will get a product, and whatever your we can do extraction of this metal here, what silver, and here what your mercury. So these are basically less stable oxides. Okay, here no any need of whatever your carbon monoxide H2 as a reducing agent. Okay, because these are less stable oxide, they can easily oxidize by heating only. Okay, and some are like that also, that are more stable oxide. Okay, so more stable oxide is what? Yes, more reactive metals, as we discuss reactivity series, more reactive metal. KB Nath ka mali aalu jara crunchy fi ke pakata hai. कौन है आगे आओ? आर यू रिमेंबरिंग ऑल दिस इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल, सॉरी रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज और एक्टिविटी सीरीज. अंडरस्टूड? सो बेटा, व्हाट एवर यूर दिस, ओके, योर पोटेशियम, बेरियम, देन योर सोडियम, कैल्शियम, देन मैग्नीशियम, एल्यूमिनियम, यस, ओके, दीज आर व्हाट, वेरी रिएक्टिव, एंड व्हाट एवर, यस, very reactive, and whatever they are oxide they are forming, that oxides are, yes, oxides are stable. What beta? Their oxides are so much stable, therefore we can't reduce this metal with the help of carbon monoxide H2. We can't reduce by these elements, okay, or NH3. So whatever this producing, whatever here oxides they are producing, suppose K, if it will form K2O, then Na2O, okay, CaO, these oxides we can, okay, we have to reduce this, but these oxide we can reduce by electrolytic reduction. What beta?
Yes, electrolytic reduction. By this method, we can reduce whatever highly oxide stable, okay, highly stable oxide and very reactive metal. Okay, so see here, concentrate on this. Whatever electrolytic reduction, okay, say electrolytic reduction. So basically, these are what? These are for highly reactive metals only. So we saw which are those, your Na, K, Mg, Al, okay, etc. These are reduced by what, beta? Electrolysis, or we can write what? Electrolysis by their respective oxides, okay, hydroxides, chlorides, okay, in molten state. But very much important here, it will reduce by their oxides, then what, hydroxides, okay, chlorides in their molten state only we can electrolyze. Whatever electrolytic reduction in molten state also only we can do this. Okay, so see here, one thing here important, whatever even theoretical aspect is very, very much important here. Okay, so you write that whatever theoretical aspect. Okay, the metals are deposited at the cathode. See, the metals are deposited at the cathode. So that cathode is what? Yes, your metal is electropositive. So cathode is what? Yes, negatively charged. Negatively charged electrode. Negatively charged electrode. Understood, beta? Okay, and whereas chlorine, what are your non-metal? If you are, suppose you are considering your NaCl, whereas chlorine is liberated. Chlorine is liberated at the anode. And your anode is what, beta? Yes, positively charged. Yes, your non-metal is already electronegative. So it will liberate it. Yes. Positively charged. Yes, electrode. I hope you understood this. And the reactions are as follows. So see how, beta, here reaction will occur at the cathode and at the anode. So first we will discuss whatever your this molten state. In molten state, how it will occur. So whatever your NaCl in molten state, what? Na++Cl-. Okay, Na++Cl-. So at cathode, yes, your metal. Okay. So see, beta, here at the cathode, what will happen at the cathode? So at the cathode, reduction will occur. What, beta? Reduction means accepting of electron, gaining of electron. Na plus plus one electron minus, that gives what, beta? Na. Okay, understood this? One thing also you keep in mind, beta, red cat and ox means reduction always at the cathode and oxidation at the anode. I hope you understood this. Reduction at the cathode, reduction means accepting of electron. Okay, understood this? Gaining of electron, and oxidation means losing of electron. Okay, losing of electron. So keep in mind this. Okay, so see here, this thing you understood. Now beta, it's time to see here, at anode what will happen? Okay, so see at the anode what will happen? Yes, Cl2, it will oxidize, so like that. Cl minus, so what you will get?
Cl2 plus 2 electron minus loss of electron. So for balancing, so like this we have to write here 2 for balancing. Means 2Cl minus, that is what, Cl2 gas, it will be liberate. And whatever your sodium solid will deposited. Okay, which process we are discussing here? Electrolysis. Which beta? Electrolysis. Lysis means breaking. Okay. So Na plus one electron minus, that is Na. So see here, one thing here also very much important. Please pay attention. Here Na plus, as you know beta, Na is always plus, sodium is always plus one charge. So for that, we have to balance with one electron, then only you will get Na. Means here plus minus. So here your item is balanced. One Na, one Na. Now it's time to balance charge. So see here plus minus zero. Here also zero charge. Understood? So our whatever this half reaction is correct. Now see if you are considering this. Pahle kya tha? Pahle only Cl minus tha. So here we wrote Cl2 because Cl2 is a gaseous. We can't write Cl gaseous. Yes, it is a diatomic. So beta here for balancing here take 2 because it is oxidation, loss of electron, gaining of electron. Loss means losing, gaining, accepting. Okay, so for that here we have to balance with 2. Okay, so here also Cl2, here also 2, 2 will negative charge, here also 2 negative, means our atom as well as charge, this and also you keep in mind. Atom and charge must balance in such type of ionic reactions. In such type of ionic reactions. I hope you understood this all. Okay. Whatever our electrolytic reduction also. Okay. So see here, whatever we will discuss next. So beta, we done this all the process. Okay. In metallurgical operation. First we done concentration of ore. Okay, dressing of ore, or we called what, enrichment of ore. Then we convert whatever that ore into metal oxide. Then that metal oxide convert into its metal with the help of reduction. Okay, so this you have to keep in mind all that reducing agent. Okay, carbon, carbon monoxide, your hydrogen and sometimes ammonia also used. And whatever your for ZnO. Zinc oxide only and only carbon is used for the reduction. As a reducing agent, carbon only used. Okay. And some we discuss oxides of metal, some less oxide, okay, less stable oxide. Whatever your silver, your mercury, we discuss. Next, what we discuss, whatever your highly reactive metal, in that we discuss this. With the help of, we took example of what, beta? Sodium. Okay, now whatever our next, so that next is what? Thermite process. So we will discuss that thermite process for joining the railway tracks. What? For joining railway tracks. Okay, that process is very much important. Okay, so in that thermite process, okay, so see here, thermite process. So that beta thermite process is very very much important. So we can done with your oxides, that is Cr2O3. Okay, then our magnetite Mn3O4. Okay, so see here, metal oxides such as Cr2O3, okay, and MnO2 are whatever. Okay, so see here, we can write here whatever our metal oxides Cr2O3, MnO2, or we can write here Mn3O4 also. Okay, Mn3O4 also are not easily reduced by, are not beta easily reduced by your carbon, then carbon monoxide and hydrogen. Okay. In such cases, beta, aluminium is used. In such cases, aluminium is used. And whatever that aluminium, why there it will use? Because it is more electropositive than this. More electropositive. Okay. So we can this whatever this process we are discussing, the thermal process, we can also called as what? Aluminotherapy. What beta? Aluminotherapy. Now we will take here one example. Okay, ready with this example. So see, CrO2O3, chromic oxide plus Al. Okay, so first here that what in solid state. So after it will convert into what? Al2O3 plus Cr. Okay, Cr. This what beta in solid, and whatever your metal you will get, that metal in what? Molten. Because here strongly heat. Okay, we have to do. Whatever your metal we will get in molten state. Okay, so this thing also very much important. Suppose if you are thinking about magnetite, Mn3O4. So we call it as the what? Magnets. So say here Mn3O4. So beta, basically Mn3 is what? Manganese second and third oxide. Okay, we can write here manganese, yes, second and third oxide. So why beta this second and third oxide? Because it is a composition of what? Yes, it is a composition of MnO and Mn2O3. MnO and Mn2O3, like that is composition. Means here by joining Mn3O4. MnO and Mn2 means here second oxidation number charge, and in Mn2O3 plus 3, that's why it is what? Mn3O4. Okay, understood this? So here also we have to take as Al as a reducing agent. So it will what? It will form. You will get Mn as a liquid molten state along with what beta? Yes, obviously your Al2O3. So for beta balancing, yes, here 8 Al, so here what? 4. Okay, then oxygen how much? Yes, oxygen 8 Al, here also 8 Al, Mn3, so beta here 3 Mn. Understood? So it will balance for oxygen. No, yes, here 12 oxygen are there. So 3 4s are 12, so 3 3s are 9, so here what? How much? 9 Mn liquid. Understood? So our reaction is balanced beta, complete. Okay, so basically these are what your thermite process. Okay, it is what beta? Highly exothermic. So whatever this we have to do in the presence of strong heat. That's why whatever your metal you are getting, it is what? In molten state. Somehow what beta? Whatever that physical state of that metal, first it is liquid. Okay, so aluminothermite process, that what? Welding of metals. Okay, then reaction of Fe2O3 with Al, whatever your hematite, okay, is used to join railway tracks or cracked machine parts, or what beta? Cracked machine parts. So this reaction where occur in whatever you are joining railway tracks, Fe2O3 plus Al. So beta, what you will get here? Simply Al2O3 plus iron solid. So for balancing, what here? 2. And Al how much? Fe2O3, yes, here also 3, 2 Al. Okay, our reaction will balance. Highly exothermic means what? Plus, we can write here, plus heat energy. Okay, see here Fe2, here also Fe2, Al2, Al2, O3, O3. Yes, our reaction is balanced. So, we will get here what beta? Yes, molten iron we will get first, because it is highly exothermic reaction. So, now if we are considering about this reaction with a pyrolusite ore. So that pyrolusite ore like this, MnO2, we call it as a what beta? Pyrolusite ore plus Al, solid. These are also solid. Then after heating, what you will get? Yes, you will get obviously here Mn along with what? Al2O3. So here 2. So for balancing, O3. So for balancing here, yes, here you have to take 3, here also 3. So see, our reaction will balance. So 2 and here what beta? 4. So once again we will check 3Mn, yes, 3Mn. Oxygen 3 to the 6, here also 6. 4L, 4L. Yes, our reaction is balanced. So these specially two reactions, it's used for joining railway tracks or cracked machine parts. Okay. Or we can write here what these are in liquid state and these are what solid state. Plus what beta? Heat energy. Heat energy. I hope you understood all this, whatever we discuss in today's lecture. Okay. If you are any doubts you are facing, then you can WhatsApp. Okay, you can send on WhatsApp. Okay, anytime. Okay, so stay safe and take care. Thank you.